decided to have a storytelling festival in February to get everybody out of their houses in midwinter and come out into the community. We have four performers tonight, three local performers, and one coming from St. Louis who should be deplaning at the moment. Hopefully. But since the weather will look good, that should have worked. We're going to start out with Jessica Bays, known as Red. On a normal day, you would know why her nickname is Red. Tonight, you might not be able to. Yes! Let's go! Welcome! Welcome to House of Speaking. I am here today to talk to you about theater and why we only borrow to go to theater. Assuming that we had left our homes. We had left our homes and we're here. Welcome. Now, I have written down some comments about the theater, if I can just find them. Let us begin with etymology, shall we? Etymology being the history of the word. The word drama comes from the Greek word drawn, which means to do, and the English word drain, meaning to exhaust one totally, and the modern pharmaceutical sedating tablet Dramamine, which is the trade name of the drug used to relieve air sickness and sea sickness and a general sense of nausea. Nausea, and Jean-Paul Sartre might say.
In my beginning is my end. My end is my beginning. History is now and always. History is now. In your head, Will, is greatness. But you don't know it yet. In your young mind, in your young life, there's greatness. Dark hair and oh yes!
Me?
Yes!
Oh,
come by here now! A lovely boy called Morfran! Morfran, which in Welsh means the great raven. And he was to be famous and he was to be a great warrior with Arthur, and we shan't worry about him very much. She had another son. I can't let you do this. He had another son. Called a Afagthu. And a Afagthu was the ugliest boy you ever did see. Oh, it hurt you to look at him. Oh, he put you up to dinner. Come in. Come in. Get higher. Hi, on your knees. On your knees, up. Up. Come on in. It won't hurt, really. No, honest. Hands over. Lip. I want a lip of a cauldron. Up here. Hands. I'm not in it! There's Lucky. Now! My cauldron of inspiration. For a year and a day! A factu! We're going to make you wise. Through the cauldron of inspiration. For a year and a day, Ceridwen took the herbs from the forest and was to pour into this and to keep a fire going and to boil it. And the first three drops from a year and a day would go to Afagthu and he would become the greatest bard in Welsh history. Well, we need a fire. Right, so, she didn't want anyone to know what she was doing, so she needed a blind man. Morda. Morda the blind he was. Could not see for looking. That's a Welsh idiom for you. Now then, you pretend to put loads of wood under there and keep the fire going. Good boy, there you go. Now.
That's a castle who can stir for me and be my servant for a year and a day.
Well, you're very poor and you said, okay, ma'am, you can go and have him. Thank you very much. Look after yourself, boy. Off he goes. Now then, you're spun for that camera now, look. Very good. Very good. You combed your hair before you came, did you? Look at this. Ow. Anyway. So anyway, for a year and a day. Yeah, what are you doing? You stop. Bubble, bubble. Now, for a year and a day, you have to get wood to keep it working. Ready? Go. Look for wood. Go. Don't move. Okay.
Walk around.
That's it. Take a piece of wood off everybody. Keep going. All right? Keeping my story interesting. There she was, climbing out of the river, and he got by a farm, and he thought, got to live on the land. I'll be so small, she won't know what I am. So he became small. Smaller. A grain of wheat. The otter turned into a hen. Do you know that's right? She turned into a hen. And she comes along. All up. All in. All swallowed. All down. Done. Did she win?
Yes.
No.
No.
No. She swallowed him. But he didn't come out. Gwyn Bach. Go sit down. Ceridwyn. Go sit down. Everybody else around the edge. Gwyn Bach. Turns into pot's gone. Gwylan Gwynedd, King of Wales, was a boastful man. No, you're blind. There he is, look! Bad king. The king had the best wife, had the best horses, had the best bards who could all sing. Oh, everybody, sit on the edge, quick, face me. Quick. Had the best of everything. But Taliesin, he went to the court. And he heard this, and he said, you know, King, I don't think you have the best horses. We have great, great horses down in Mumbles, by South Wales. He says, my mom, my foster mom, she's the most beautiful woman you ever did meet. She is. As for your bards, well, I don't think they can foretell the future. And tell you, you need a stick. Where's your stick? So, how you doing? Ready? Can you hold it? Oh, can you wave that wand? Wave your wand over all those bards. Oh, good wave. So whereas you were thinking you would tell a wonderful prophecy, can you all do this? You have to go. Brerum. Say it together. Brerum. He's very good at rolling his R. He's terrible and ugly, but he's good at rolling. Do it for him.
Granddad was a farmer. He never earned a lot, though he and Grandma worked hard every day. They raised 5 children. Soon as they could walk, he taught them how to milk and hoe and hay. Esther was the oldest. She married a boy from school, had a child in 1959. Granddad came to visit, hold the little child, and say some words about the family line. Grandfather stood in the doorway and silver dollar that he had left for his grandchild.